Born in the streets of Texas, a young actor by the name of Farisa Jordan brings her talent all the way to New York City to pursue her acting career. After arriving in New York City, Farisa Jordan enrolled in Fordham University in the Bronx.
It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under. It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under.
While in New York, Farisa Jordan started her one-woman play, which began to get attention from producers and directors across the New York City tri-state area.
Can't take the noise, got no money to move out, I guess I got no choice. Rats in the front room, roaches in the back, junkies in the alley with the baseball bat. I tried to get away, but I couldn't get far, cause a man with a tow truck repossessed my car. Don't push me, cause I'm close to the edge. I'm trying not to lose my head. It's like a jungle sometimes. It makes me wonder how I keep from going.
Welcome back, everybody, right here on The What. And I have my new guest, Farisa Jordan, an up-and-coming actress here in New York City, about to open up your own show at the New Yorican Cafe, located on 3rd Street between Avenues B and C.
Yes.
And that show is beginning from March 26th through the 28th?
Yes.
That's a Saturday, Sunday, and Monday, correct?
Yes.
That's great. An actress, I'm an actor, I have great respect for your work, and I'm actually going to the show, and tell me a little bit about how you started out here. I know you grew up in Texas, Houston.
Yes, I'm from Texas, and I came to New York to study theater at Fordham about 3 years ago, and I graduated in December.
Great, great.
So
that's great. Now you're about to actually take theory into practice.
Exactly.
Right?
Yes.
And it's not that easy, actually, as anyone in the entertainment business knows. Now, tell me, I know you have done some work in theater at school.
Yes.
Now, how do you think that's going to translate, actually, to work professionally?
Well, it's translated right now, just working on the One Woman Show, is really being able to put forth everything I've learned about writing, about performance, about collaborating with other artists, and so it's
that's good. And in terms of your work ethic, it's much different going to class rather than going to perform or actually rehearse to perform, correct? Because the stakes are much higher, you have some money, some investment involved. How do you feel? Do you think that makes you perform better, or tell me, is it a positive or a negative?
Definitely, I think it does, especially because it's a one-woman show that I wrote and that, you know, I'm working on. You get more of a sense of being more in control of your craft.
See, I didn't know that you had actually wrote it. That's great. That's great. Have you had this concept for a while, or?
I actually started working on it at school. I took a class where we were to put on a 7-minute show, and so I did that. Really enjoyed it. I thought there was more to it, so I started writing on it.
That's great. So. That's great. The other thing, in Texas, I know you've done some work.
Yes.
Now, I've never been to Texas. Mm-hmm. And the first thing that comes to mind when I think of Texas is the cowboys, and for some reason, cattle. I always picture a lot of cows roaming around. But
no.
There's not a lot of room. There's not a lot of theater work in terms of entertainment in Houston, per
right.
se. But
right.
what have you done there?
I did. I was connected with a theater called Corrine Farrow,
uh-huh.
and I did some work with them. I did some. I was in For Colored Girls, a production of that,
uh-huh.
and also the Colored Museum there.
That's great.
So.
That's great. And now, you booked this one-woman show with?
With Parlay Entertainment.
That's great. How did you get connected with them?
You know, me and Kevin Parlay of Parlay Entertainment, we just had mutual acquaintances, and we just kind of linked up.
That's great. So we're going to be seeing Friso Cafe at the Eurekan Cafe.
New Eurekan Cafe.
New Eurekan Cafe.
Yes.
On 3rd Street between Avenues B and C, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, March 26th through the 28th. Don't miss it, because I will be there.
Okay.
Thank you for coming on the show.
Thank you
very much. Don't go anywhere, because right next up, we got a new brand new guest holding your seat. Be right back.